Let's draw the Lewis structure for N2. This is diatomic nitrogen, sometimes just called nitrogen gas. The first thing we do with Lewis structures, we count the total number of valence electrons. Let's use the periodic table to do that. So we find nitrogen right here, group 15, sometimes called 5A. Nitrogen has 5 valence electrons. So we have 5, we have 2 nitrogen atoms, 5 times 2. That gives us a total of 10 valence electrons for the N2 Lewis structure. With Lewis structures, we put the least electronegative atom in the center, but these are both nitrogens, so their electronegativity is the same. So let's just put 2 nitrogen atoms, and then we'll put 2 electrons between these atoms to form the chemical bond, like this. That's our covalent bond. Next, let's complete the octets for each nitrogen atom. But we immediately run into a problem. We've used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. That's all we have, and we've not completed the octet for the nitrogen here. Here's how we fix this. We can share electrons since we have 2 nonmetals here, so we could move these 2 here to the center to form a double bond. Now we're still using 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, but we have 8 on this nitrogen and only 6 on this nitrogen. Let's move another pair to the center here. So now we have a triple bond. This nitrogen has 8, that's an octet. This nitrogen has 8, that's an octet. And we're only using 10 valence electrons. So this is the Lewis structure for nitrogen. Often you'll see these valence electrons put on the end, which makes sense because with only 2 atoms, we have a linear molecular geometry. Sometimes you'll see the triple bond written like this, where each line represents a pair of electrons shared between the nitrogen atoms. So that's it. This is the Lewis structure for N2, diatomic nitrogen, or sometimes just called nitrogen gas. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.